Hi guys, welcome to WebSense Pro. Welcome to another video. In this video, I'll show you guys how you can add custom input field to your Shopify product page. And the reason why you should have custom input field is that if you are selling a print on demand product and you want your user to give you input about what they want to print on the product which they are buying, you can use this trick and you don't want to pay for any app to get this additional feature on your product page. Currently, you are unable to do that from the Shopify backend. You'll have to add a little piece of code, which I'm going to show you how you can generate. It's pretty easy. All you have to do is just follow this video, comment down on the video below and let me know what you liked about this video and what more you would like to learn in the Shopify. So without further ado, let's jump into the screen where I'll show you guys how you can add custom input field to your Shopify product page. So as you can see that on my screen, I have this custom label input field on my Shopify product page. And if I click on add to cart, it is a required field and it won't let me proceed without adding the value. Okay. Now, if I add in any value and click on add to cart, you can see that my value is being passed on to the cart page. And if I go to the checkout page, you can see that the value of my custom input field is being passed to the checkout page as well. And we have created this Shopify UI element generator for you guys in which you can add in the field. So we have added the short text field and that's the label which we can add. We can add any custom label or if you want to take input from user, custom input field. So as you can see, that's field preview. So that's how it's going to look like on your product page. And that's the liquid code. So all you have to do is just copy this liquid code and add into your customized theme settings. And I'm going to show you how you can do that really easily. At the end of this video, I'm also going to show you guys how you can add these fields on specific product. So if you have multiple products and you want the custom fields to show up on specific products, this video will help you do that as well. Okay, so first thing I'm going to do, I'm going to go to my development store backend. Okay guys, so I'm logged into my development store. Now let's click on online store. And here, as you can see, I have Dawn 12.0.0 activated. Now what I'm gonna do, I'll test the code from the Shopify UI element, UI field generator to a different theme. Let's try on the Spotlight theme if it's working properly or not, because all of these theme is supportable by the field, by the code which we are generating through Shopify UI elements generator. So let's try it on Spotlight theme. I'm going to add in the Spotlight theme. Okay guys, our Spotlight theme has been installed. Now let's publish this theme. And now I'm going to preview my product page. So that's the Spotlight theme and that's how my product page looks like right now. What we're going to do, we will use Shopify UI element generator and add in our custom input field below the pricing. Okay. Now let's go to themes and then click on customize. And from customize, click on the dropdown and then click on products. Then we have our default product template. Click on that. And now it's showing our product page template. Now let's add in the block from add block button here and then select custom liquid. Now click on custom liquid and here we will add the custom input field code which will be generated through Shopify UI element generator. So that's our Shopify UI element generator. I'll put the link of this element generator in the YouTube video description so you guys can easily find that out. Okay, so we need short text field and we need custom product label field and we want this field as required field. We can also add the optional field. So if we uncheck this checkbox, the field will be optional. That's the preview of the field. But for now, we need it as a required field. So we'll check this checkbox. Okay, now we will copy this liquid code. So just click on copy code and our liquid code above showing will be copied automatically. Now let's just paste in our liquid code in the custom liquid code block which we added. And here we go, our custom product label is showing up. Now let's move it below the pricing. So I'm going to drag and drop below the price. And here we go, our custom product label is showing up. Now click on save and then preview our product. Okay, let's go to hat. And here you go, our custom product label is showing up. Now let's add in testing value to see if it's passing on the value to the cart page and to the checkout page, right? First we'll have to clear up the cart. Okay, I'm going to clear up the cart because we already had one product in the cart. Now let's go back and add in our testing value to our custom product label. Click on add to cart. And here you can see it's passed to our cart page. Now we will check if it's passing on to the checkout. Let's click on checkout. Now you can see it's passing on this value to the checkout page as well. So our code is completely working fine. We can use our Shopify UI element generator to add in the fields to any of the Shopify 2.0 themes, no matter it's Dawn theme, Fresh theme, Sense theme, Color Block, Spotlight, whatever 2.0 themes we have in Shopify theme store, we can use this Shopify UI element generator to add in the custom product options field. Cool, right? Now, one thing is that this field is showing up on all of the products. So if we go to the second product which we have on our development store, so we currently have two products in our development store. We added this field on hat product page, but we actually added that in our default product template, meaning it will show up on all of the product pages. So if I go on to the second product, you can see that it's showing up there as well. What if you want to add this field only on specific product? What if you want to add some fields to only specific products and some other fields on some other products? You can do that really easy. So first way to do that is by adding an if condition from the custom liquid code. So for example, if I want this field to display only on the products which contains shirt on the product name, we can do that by adding the liquid code. So we added our custom field in custom liquid. Now all we need to do is just wrap the code in if condition. So we'll be adding an if condition on the top. So if product dot title contains shirt. Now I'm going to add and if. And that's it. Now this field will only show up on products which includes shirt in the name of the products. Now as you can see, the minute I added this condition, our field is not showing up on a hat product anymore. Now let's save it and test out on the product which contains shirt in the product title. So here's our shirt product, and if I hit refresh, you can see that our field is still showing up. But if I go to the different product, hat, this field is no longer visible. So that's a pretty easy way on how you can display these fields on specific products. Now there's another way. What you can do is create a template. Now we are on our default product template. Let's delete this field. Delete this custom liquid from our default product and add in to a newly created product template. And then we will assign that product template to the specific product. Okay, now let's remove this custom liquid. Hit save. And now here on the dropdown, let's go to products and then create a new template. Click on create template. Now let's name it special. So you can assign this special template to those specific product where you want to display the fields, right? Now click on create template. And here we will add our custom input field. So again, click on add block. click on custom liquid, click on custom liquid again, and then copy the code from our Shopify UI element generator. Click on copy code, paste the code to our customize settings, and then hit save. Again, I'm going to move it below the pricing. So drag and drop below the price, hit save. And now when I go to any of the product on my store, so let's hit refresh and check any of the products. You can see that field is not showing up on any of the product. The reason why is that because we haven't assigned the template to those products. Now let's go to the products. And we have only two products in our product inventory. Now I'm going to assign the template which I created on the t-shirt product. Click on that product where we want to assign the template. Scroll down, and here we have the option to assign the template. So that's the template which we created called special. Now let's click on that and hit save. And now let's preview the product. Now you can see that the custom input field is being displayed on the product, specifically on the t-shirt product, because that's the only product where special template is assigned, right? So that's it, guys. That's an easiest way on how you can add input field to your product page, which will move value, pass value to the cart and pass value to the checkout as well. And don't forget to check out the other field options which we have in Shopify UI field generator. You can add in long text field, you can add file upload field, you can add checkboxes, you can add radio buttons, you can add drop down and the date type field to your Shopify product page, and all of these fields will pass on value to the cart and then to the checkout. Also, it will display it to the product summary. So if I go to orders, and that's an order which I already added as a test order. Now you can see that it's displaying this custom file upload field on the product summary page. So you will have the value on the cart, checkout, and the order summary page as well, whatever fields you generate from our Shopify UI field generator. So that's it for the video, guys. I hope you guys would like it, and I'll definitely create some more videos related to adding radio buttons, checkboxes, and some other stuff related to Shopify. Let me know in the comments below what more you would like to learn. Thanks for the feedback. I've been getting a lot of comments regarding different tutorial ideas. Me and my team is working hard to catch up with those requests, because there are a lot of requests, and it's just a matter of time we'll be releasing those videos for you in this channel. So don't forget to subscribe and turn on the notification bell icon so you can get notified until next video. Have a great day.